Hello, today we are going to be going over how to do a viscous analysis in XFLR5. First, you want to create a new project and find various airfoil shapes. Create a 2412 and a 0010. Then create flaps both up and down for the 2412 as pictured here. You can pause the video and create the airfoils. Now to go over how to change color and style. It is important to go over how to change colors in the designer to make them visually distinct, because it's important for differentiating them in the direct foil analysis. Go over to the right side of the airfoil and left-click on the colored line under Style. Left-click on the color and move over to select the new color choice. I would recommend going through the colors of the rainbow in order to maximize color differentiation and keep everything clear in your head. You can also edit the symbols of the lines to distinguish them, and you can make them thicker using width to better see them. The various symbols are circles, squares, triangles, and X's. Now make sure to give each airfoil you create a distinct color to each foil, and make sure that show is checked next to the airfoil. After that, go to Module, X-Foil Direct Analysis. Select the airfoil that you want to create an analysis for. We will start with the 2412. Go to Analysis, Define Analysis, and you will see Type 1 as the first option. This analysis runs on two main variables, the Reynolds number and the Mach value, or the Mach speed. The Mach speed is equal to the speed of the plane in meters per second divided by 343. For example, an estimated speed we used in the 2023 year was 42 meters per second. So 42 divided by 343 meters per second equals Mach 0.12. The Reynolds number is a dimensionless quantity that relates the volume of the airfoil to its surface area. In order to figure out what that would be, we can go to Wing and Plane Design. And here I have now defined two different chords of wings. The smaller one is defined by red and the larger one is cyan. So if we go to the OP point view, we can see that the cyan one has a Reynolds number of 240,000, while the red one has a Reynolds number of 120,000. This makes sense since the smaller chord has half the chord of the larger one. So we can go back to Module X-Foil Direct Analysis and create and edit the analysis, or create a new one, and set the Reynolds number to 240,000. For the analysis settings, we can set the start angle to negative 20 degrees and the end angle to positive 20 degrees with an increment of 1 degree and analyze. Automatically, it should reset the scales for each of the graphs, and you'll end up with results looking like this. As you can see on the coefficient of lift graph, it reaches very negative values and very positive values at its more extreme angles, and then both start to stall off to a lower absolute value as they pass that number. For the coefficient of drag, it gets more extreme to both extremely positive and extremely negative angles, and the coefficient of moment graph varies more irregularly. After that, we will go to the various flap designs and create similar analyses for both of those. Run the analysis, create the final analysis, and run it. And now you have three distinct graphs for each of these. Oh, by the way, if you are only seeing one graph, you can go to Graphs and then select Four Graphs, and to edit the various quantities, right click on the graph you want to change, and go to current graph, define graph settings. The various y values we are using are coefficient of lift, coefficient of moment, coefficient of drag, and CP min, or minimum coefficient of pressure. The x-axis is always alpha. As you can see on the design with the flaps angled down, which is colored green with X's, the coefficient of lift is much more positive than the ordinary airfoil and starts to hit its maximum coefficient of lift at a slightly smaller angle than the regular airfoil, meaning that this design will produce large amounts of positive lift, elevating the plane to a higher altitude. The design with the flaps angled upwards has mostly negative values for coefficient of lift, meaning that when the flaps are up, the plane will want to descend to a lower altitude. After you are done defining the analyses for the 2412 configurations, you can go to the NACA 0010, go to Analysis, and go to Batch Analysis. This will allow you to analyze various different Reynolds numbers with similar conditions. Here we have the Reynolds numbers defined from 5,000 to 240,000, which was the larger of the two wings. And I'm going to add a much larger one in order to compare to the various different Reynolds numbers. Click Analyze, and we'll begin creating the conditions for analysis. Once it has completed the analysis, exit out and click the drop-down arrow for the NACA 0010. Here is the 5,000, Reynolds number of 5,000. This is the 120,000. Is slightly steeper. The 240,000 is very similar performance shape with coefficient of lift compared to the 120,000. And when the Reynolds number is 1 million, it actually more closely follows the 5,000 and has a relatively low angled line with minimal variation at more extreme angles. Most of the time, we will have a predetermined Reynolds number based on the optimizer's calculations. So we can usually stick with type 1 style analyses. That was all I have to cover on viscous analysis for today. Thank you and have a great day.